I'm here to make the case. This just could be the best thing that has happened to Tiger Woods in the last 6 years of no major championships.
Really?
I'm here to say that because if you could tell me that Tiger will be healthy enough to play at Augusta, play the Masters, even if he doesn't play another tournament, if he doesn't go to San Antonio to play the Texas Open, or he's never played the Shell Open in Houston the week before the Masters, I'm doubting he's going to play either one. But even if he doesn't, I believe this will give him the best chance to win a tournament he should be owning. He should have owned for a long time, and he's only won it 4 times, and that's the Masters. And my thought is, do you know what's happened over the last couple of years? How often has Tiger Woods won his last tournament before he plays a major championship? We've seen it again and again and again. Expectations have gone through the sky, gone into the heavens, that it's time. Tiger Woods is finally going to break back through since the 08 U.S. Open, which he won on one leg, the last time he won a major championship, and he's going to win another major. Overhyped, overanalyzed, and expectations that he cannot live up to at age 38. But this time, if he's healthy enough to go to Augusta, if he can get his back right, and it doesn't seem that bad, but what do I know? If he doesn't need surgery on his back, if this just is a chiropractic kind of an issue, and he can show up, dare I say, quietly at Augusta National with low expectations, nobody thinking much of anything, and he kind of eases into the flow with maybe a even par 72 the first day, and all of a sudden by Saturday he makes his charge, and what? Tiger Woods won the Masters? Are you kidding me? Who saw that coming? Well, I'm here to say, if he gets there on schedule, healthy, I'm going to pick him to win the Masters. Now I'm creating expectations.
Right.
But that's how strongly I feel about how he's shaping up off his worst start to a pro year that he's ever had.
I completely disagree with you, Skip Bayless, and it's because of all the reasons that you pointed out, but primarily because of one above all else, and that is this: if he shows up quietly. There's no such thing as quietly in Tiger Woods.
Well, relatively quietly.
There's always going to be noise where he's concerned. I'm looking at some of this stuff. You know, missed a 54-hole cut in the Farmers Insurance Open, tied for 80th, tied for 41st in the Dubai Desert Classic. I'm looking at that. You know, withdrew from the Honda Classic, tied for 25th in the Cadillac Championship. When he went the final 18 holes, didn't make a birdie and shot a 78, the worst final round of his career. I'm looking at all of these things, and then I'm looking at this stuff. Skip, I pay attention to this stuff because it matters. The ankle injury, the knees, I'm sorry, the Achilles, and then
I'm just looking, and then
you combine that with the back spasms. I understand that basketball is a different sport. I understand that baseball is a different sport, but I'm thinking about the injuries per se because of how it hinders your ability to be all you can be. The Achilles, the knee, fine.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
But golf, and you got a back problem?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, everything's about twisting and turning. Mm-hmm. So to me, Skip, if you're saying this next year, that's fine. But with the Masters just weeks away, no, Skip. I don't see Tiger having any kind of success this year, but because I don't see him getting healthy that soon. I think that Tiger, his career is in jeopardy because I don't know if he can be healthy again. If you can't be healthy, these dudes on the circuit with him, they're not scared of him. And they can play. And so you've got to, Tiger could beat them all if he can be on his A game. My problem with Tiger is that I don't believe his health will allow him to reach his A game potential. And that's my issue.
Okay.
I can't see it.
The problem with this discussion is, I don't know.
We don't know
about what his health really is. And he's always very circumspect about what he gives the media in way
he
of detail
be.
About what his back
and
really
he
is. He's having back issues, back spasms, he says. Okay. What does that mean exactly? Do you have a herniated disc or not? Because if it's herniated and you need that Tony Romo surgery, well, then we have a whole different discussion.